Welcome to the Don Serious Show. From thought-provoking discussions on current affairs to deep dives into the worldly landscape, the Don Serious Show covers it all. Each episode is a tapestry of diverse topics designed to enlighten, entertain, and expand your thinking.
Welcome to the Don Serious Show. I'm your host, Don Serious. I'm here with a special guest. His name is Marty Meech. He's out of the Chicago area. We're here to enlighten you, and I want you to enjoy his presence. I'm happy to have him on the show. Thank you for joining. I would like for you to hit the like button, subscribe, turn on the bell so you can get a notification when I have a show for you to watch. So let's check him out. I'm going to bring him up. Thank you for joining us. And don't forget to drop some comments because we're here for the algorithm and the analytics. And we're here to enlighten you once again. What's up, Mr. Marty Meech?
Big Don, how you be, baby?
Hey, I'm here, man. I'm glad to have you on the show. You know what I'm saying?
Hey, I see you got that Batman on, man. I like that Batman.
I'm Batman. Yeah, I'm Batman once I found out Superman got his ass whooped by Batman. Who wants to get in the
ass? That was crazy, wasn't it?
Yeah, by a fucking mortal, and you're not a mortal. Like, nah, I don't fuck with Superman no more, you know what I'm saying? Even though, on a side note, because I do these side notes, Superman is actually his... Oh, wow, look at that. I didn't know they could do that. But anyway, Superman, they got that whole Superman thing from the DNA of a black man, you know what I'm saying? Because, like, black people love the sun. We need the sun. So Superman needs the sun. And let's not go into all his attributes. And then, like, they also let you know what they think of other humans because he's, like, acting like he's inferior when he's got the glasses on. So, you know, Superman came from a black person. Let's just leave it at that, you know?
Yeah.
So what's good, man?
Oh, nothing much, man. Just chilling, man. Home with the family. Maxing and relaxing. You know what I mean?
Oh, that's what's up, man. Like, family is always good, man. Other people don't get to appreciate that shit. But that's a good thing.
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Blessing to have it, for sure.
I'm very grateful that you came on here. I've been knowing you for many, many moons and many, many suns in rotation. And I'm happy to even have you on the show and you be a part of my show. I'm very grateful. Yes, sir.
Yeah, appreciate it, man. I was excited to hear about the show and excited to participate. And the best part about it is I get to, you know what I'm saying, hop on here, speak with my friend about real conversations that we normally have, but being able to bring it to the masses.
Nice. You are 100% accurate, and I like the fact that I created this platform and show because we are intelligent human beings, and we have a lot to share with the world, and I like the fact that this platform allows me to get the opportunity to enlighten people, share knowledge and experience, and hopefully it will help somebody. The topic was going to be the benefits of a woman's love. Oh, I know a lot of niggas are going to be out here on some sucker-hating-ass nigga shit, but who gives a fuck, nigga? You're going to be old and lonely as fuck. Nigga, I ain't trying to go that fucking route, bro. You know what I mean? Like, I understand some people were, like, raised and born in an environment and certain things or whatever, but, man, let's get to the motherfucking topic, the benefit of a woman's love, man. May Marty Meech speak first because he's very intelligent and has a lot of experience and ups and downs, and I would like to hear your perspective, sir.
Man. The benefits of a woman's love. Is something that is a new lesson that I learned, I would say, in the past maybe 4 years, 5 years, coming all the way up until now, I'm able to look back and see the benefits of a real woman's love. And it's unbelievable. Unbelievable. The motivation, the strength, the awareness that a woman's love could provide to you, just because a man, we definitely used to chasing women, all this. If you that type of dude, you know what I'm saying? You holler at women. But we have one woman, and when we have one woman, now we still have to do our chase and pursuit and everything, but now it's just of you. And that's, and if you have a woman that loves you, it's going to be fun to do that.
Yeah, man.
It's going to be real fun to chase her every day. You know what I'm saying? In a great way, because you, like, you know what I'm saying? If it was a female that you worked with or something, and you was trying to get to know her, holler and anything, you would give her a little time and attention and all that. But the same thing that you did to get her is the same thing you need to keep doing to keep her. So,
okay,
make sure you play the situation correctly and take your time, because a woman is delicate. And if she giving, going to the extent of actually opening her heart and allowing you to come in and look around, you know
what I'm saying? Yeah, yeah, I like that. Look then, around, like, pretty nice in here, you know?
You know, but if she goes to the extent of doing that, then you have to make sure that you're doing the correct things to keep that woman. Because I always say when I was young, or remember when I was young, that, and I was raised by my father, so I was like, man, I know that a man could raise a man to be a man, but a man can't show a man how to be a man for a woman.
Okay.
It would take, it would take for that woman to show that man how to be the man for her.
Yeah, but that's important to me right there, that part, what you just said right there.
Yeah. Yeah, she got to know how to do that, though, and want to have the want to do that for that man. But if she ain't got the want, desire to do that, then she ain't going to do that, and she just, you know what I'm saying, going through the motions. And if you a man that's looking for a woman that isn't going through the motions and looking for a man to hold her down and be there and y'all build something together, if y'all on the same frequency, then it's going to work. If y'all not, then it's not. It's going to be some friction, and you wonder why you have some friction.
Yeah, you get pressure bust pipes, you know what I'm saying? If it's too much pressure, you know what I mean? It ain't gonna work, you know what I mean?
If it's just two different agendas, you know?
Yeah,
like,
I like that.
Like, she want to love you, and you want to love 52 other females, and wonder why she cussing your ass out.
Yeah, I agree with you on that, man. I mean, you know, especially if y'all on the same frequency, man, it's a beautiful thing, bro. It's actually marvelous. You know, fuck that wonderful. It's marvelous. I speak from experience, truthfully. Yeah, man. When you said a woman, if she's willing to show you and teach you how, I'm going to use the word teach you how to enlighten you on how to love her and everything. Is that, did I get that part right? Did I get it right?
Yeah, correctly.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah, yeah. That's the key ingredient for me as well, because in the past, I've dated other women, and they expected me to know what they like, what they want, and everything. I don't know what went on each woman's mind or head, but when you actually bump into the right one and the chemistry, the frequency, the vibration, the magic, the mysticism, everything is like there, it becomes like really easy, fun. As you say, you still continue to chase her. It becomes fun because this person, or this woman rather, is taking time with you to enlighten you about what makes her happy, what makes her sad, what makes her feel like a queen, what her dreams are, what her ambitions are. And it allows you to focus on the cat and mouse chase fun part and build this camaraderie and friendship, and like where you and her can enjoy life, laugh together, and also talking about building together and observe action more than words. Am I on track with this, man?
Hey, you tracking. You dead on track. And what is one of the main benefits with all of that you said? As far as what you're giving her and chasing her and that thing, what is one main benefit that you receive?
Let me give some serious thought, but not think too hard. What are the main benefits that
out of what you just said, out of everything that you said that she was giving you?
What do I receive? I don't know. I mean, I don't.
The same thing that you giving her.
Yeah. Okay. That makes
same
a lot of
thing
sense.
Because she's.
I just look at it like that's happiness for me.
Say what?
I look at it like that's happiness for me, because that's the only reason why it is working, because it's a circulating thing. It's revolving. It's reciprocating. It's equal or equally yoked experience with the woman, the benefits of a woman that you love, you know?
Yeah. Yeah, y'all that want the same quality thing. You know, she want to see you. She wants you to be happy. You want her to be happy. You know what I'm saying? So as long as you doing your job to make her happy, she going to be on her job to make you happy. And when you had that communication and that open line of communication to say, hey, it was something that had happened earlier that I didn't necessarily like, I wanted to talk about it, as opposed to going straight to cussing them out or being upset with them or whatever. You know, you are going to have those emotions where you immediately get upset or whatever the case may be. But that's when you got to check yourself, like, man, this person loves me. I love them. So let me not come at them in a disrespectful way, because if they got upset, they entitled to get upset too. You know what I'm saying? But I wouldn't want for them to come at me recklessly. You know what I'm saying? So I would, I got to practice what I preach.
I agree. And see, let's see where I can, you know, lead with this without doing the ands and ums. So
what I'm working on that as well, for sure. I was just watching a little video with the ands and ums. I'm like, man, I mean, it's the pause. I was telling you about the little try to attempt to pause when you get ready to say the and the ." And I didn't say it and 12 times already.
What do you think I'm doing? You think I'm doing well?
Oh, fantastic, brother. Fantastic. Cause you in your zone and you focused, but you focus on something that is natural for you, which is this new love that you're in.
Very new and exciting, which I love the feeling, and I'm very happy. Full stop.
Full stop. On the rail. Yeah. That's all it is. On the rail. If you're happy and you know it, clap your hands.
Yeah, man. For real. So one thing I noticed from this experience, and I definitely do not want it to vanish or relinquish, I do want to improve and continue to work positively towards the betterment of both of us together as one. Yes.
Yeah.
I enjoy this. So where I'm going with this is that I've noticed that when I'm around other women, or I hear them ranting and raving or using foul words, they seem a little bit harsh. When you led to that part about the woman is going to show you how she wants to be loved, I've noticed from my experience that when they open themselves up because they care about you, they really respecting you, they trust you and believe in you, then another door opens up, and then they teach you some things that you as a man and your father or the many like cannot show you from a woman's perspective. And one thing I learned is that a lot of women that, you know, want to be loved, and a lot of men that want to be loved, the women are going to try to educate you on how to allow them to get into their femininity, their soft side, because a lot of times they've been through a lot of different relationships or by themselves, and everything is on them, and they don't have the ability to just be soft because they got to worry about rent, car note, electric bill, utility bill, cell phone bill. If they got a pet, they got to figure out how to get the pet food. They got a job they got to go to. They got to answer to another boss. They got to be on time. They got a lot of things going on. And at the same time, they still got their feminine things going on, like this menstrual, the cycle, the hair. They want to look nice. They want to get their nails
emotions
done.
Emotions and shit. They got emotions. 77 times a second.
Yeah, yeah. So a lot of cats out there, man, as dudes, they like really overlook this stuff. And some of them are not even built to be with a woman like the women, you know, where we could benefit from their love. And when they allow us into their life and they educate us on this thing, then we started to realize, like, you know what? It ain't a simp to, like, be, you know, doing these things for your woman or the woman you love or the woman you married to. It's actually your responsibility as a man and your role as a man to do these things so you can allow your woman to be in her feminine energy, because she educated me by saying if a woman can get in their feminine energy and be soft, there's no limit to what her man can have in this world. And I see that now. I'm experiencing it now because I had confidence without a woman. I believed in myself without a woman. But when this woman came into my life, I have another whole level of energy I'm gaining.
The Don Serious Show.